So our next question is, what about this time of year has the most meaning?
The most meaning this time of year. I love Christmas Eve service at church. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's one of my favorite services of the year. Is that too big, by the way?
It's a little bit big, but you have to roll it in the Christmas sugar to drive home the Christmas points.
Because you got to make your chocolate chip cookies Christmas cookies,
yes.
And the only way you can do that is by
rolling it in Christmas sugar.
But I love Christmas Eve service at church. It's one of my favorite services of the year because we do it all together as a church family, kids and everything, and we do candlelight ceremony and. Just read the Christmas story, and it kind of just starts off the Christmas weekend with the whole focus of it. And, you know, everybody hears this all the time. Christmas has become so about everything other than Christ. And so that kind of, for me, is the most special thing. And then the next most special thing right behind that is Cowboy football.
Oh, wow.
I mean,
and we're back
just
to
amazing.
That.
We should still make some more cookies here.
Yes.
Okay. So the next question that we have is, who takes the lead on Christmas decorating?
That's an easy one. Why are you even thinking about that one?
Me, right?
Yeah, of course. Not even close.
Me. I would say me inside and him outside. We didn't do outside this year, though. He didn't do outside this year. But when we do outside stuff, it's definitely him. But I do inside stuff.
I haven't really done outside in quite some years.
A couple of years.
It used to be that I would do outside a lot. In our old house, we had a porch out mm-hmm. in front, and we had speakers outside. And so I put on my Barry Manilow Christmas, which is my favorite Christmas album of all time.
This is true.
And I would do all the lights and stuff like that. It would take me hours upon hours. And then I suddenly realized Christmas weekend for me is like a busy week. I'm putting up all the lights, that's hours. I'm putting together all the kids' toys, that's hours. I'm packing the car, that's hours. And I'm like, I've got to pull out of some of this stuff. And no, I'm just playing.
But, well, that's why you have to decorate the outside in November.
Yes, but now she does all of that. And as you can see, our house looks very, very nice for Christmas time. And so, yeah, you're the
decorator. And it's fun. It's fun, we enjoy it.
Awesome, all right, so, this is a hot take.
It is.
Should people play Christmas music before Thanksgiving?
Negative.
What do you say?
I say no. So what we always
do. We ran out. We need more.
I have to make another concoction of sugar.
They're not going to be Christmas cookies if you don't give us those.
That's right. So what we always did was, because we traveled for Thanksgiving Day, we were allowed to play Christmas music on our way home from Thanksgiving celebration. And so that was always the kickoff for us. And then the next day we would put our tree up. So I say after. You say?
Well, personally, I don't even think about Christmas till after Thanksgiving. I don't know why. My mind doesn't kind of work that way. But then as soon as Thanksgiving's over, immediately, like, the penny for Christmas drops for me.
Mm-hmm.
But I guess I would say not until after Thanksgiving, just because of that.
Just because of that. And if you guys weren't here, we would be totally playing Christmas music right now.
We'd have Barry Manilow.
We'd have Barry Manilow playing. Mm-hmm. It's true. It is true.
Pastor Lisa, do you like Barry Manilow?
I do. I do. Full disclosure, I do. Do I like Barry Manilow or do I like Barry Manilow's Christmas album? Yes, I do.
Well, I don't know if you like or dislike Barry
Manilow.
You never met the guy.
I don't know
if we like him or not.
Exactly. That is very true.